Hey, how's it going, everybody? Thanks again for tuning in to the channel for another track guide. We're going to look again at the ARC car. I really do love driving these things at Darlington. Tough track. It's really finicky. It'll bite you. It's really hard on tires, but it's a really fun track. And these cars are fun here. So, looking forward to this week. One of the things that kind of stinks this week about this track is that the gear ratios are kind of bad, so you're going to end up on a quick lap hitting the rev limiter down the back straightaway when you're like three quarters down the back stretch. So watch out this week for people to get frustrated and absolutely dive bomb into turn three. I feel like that's going to be a pretty common sight this week. You're also going to see me hit the wall in practice a lot because I was just trying out different things. We'll talk about that more later. So, yeah, watch out for turn three dive bombers because they're going to get frustrated that they got such a good run coming out of turn two, but they couldn't do anything with it because they ran out of gear and everybody was going the same speed. This setup is a little bit tight into the corner as you go through a run, and it's somewhat loose off if you get the car pointed the right way. So to try to help with the entry, I usually move the brake bias towards the rear once again by a pretty good bit. I think the default is 68% front brake, and I move it to 66.5 to start the race, and I might even dial it back more. I don't use a ton of brake getting into the corner, but it really does help to not eat up that right front tire. And another thing that I'd like to talk about is this track is really big about loading up the suspension and getting into a corner. So, for example, here, skip ahead to this lap. Oh, my cursor's going crazy. So, what I mean by loading up the suspension is you see, we got the steering wheel straight coming through here. And then right here, we start turning in very lightly before we really start turning the wheel and cranking it, getting into the corner. What that's doing is the inertia and the physics of the car, it wants to keep going straight. So by giving a little bit of steering input getting into the corner, you're lightly shifting the weight balance over and kind of preparing the suspension and the tires that you're about to start cornering. And since you have the weight already kind of loaded up on that wheel, on that right front tire, it has a little bit more grip and it will work with you better to turn into the corner. If you wait real late and turn in really late and you put in a lot of steering really quickly, the car is not ready for that. So the front tires are going to want to break loose and the car is going to understeer towards the wall, and it's going to be a lot harder for you as the run goes on. So that'll be something to look out for. You also don't have to get back to the throttle super hard immediately at this track. It's not like some of the larger, like, mile and a half and 2 mile tracks. At Darlington, it's okay if you're maybe 70 or 80% throttle through the corner, just holding what they call management throttle through the turn, just to keep the car where you want it, make it point where you need it to point, and kind of work with the steering as you're moving through the corners. And you'll see on the faster laps here that I found going through turn one and two, you want to turn down a little bit later. So what I do is, you see, I enter about midway and I let the car ride up to the wall, but I hold it here for a little bit and then I turn down later. So this track's got what I would consider to be later apex corners. And so I kind of hold the car where I want it until I'm ready to turn down. I'm not on this white line all the way through the corner. And I do the same thing in turn three and four. Coming out of four, I try to turn down a little bit later. You almost want to run like a diamond pattern sometimes in these corners, especially over long runs. So you might enter midway through the corner and you'll let the car ride up and kind of keep it there before you turn back down. But that is the key thing, is you want to turn down and get the car pointed on your way out of the corner. You can find some speed if you keep the car up top. I'm not real great at that, so that's kind of my driving style. It usually works for me, and I get all right finishes here. So that's one of the other key things. So let's go to one of my cleaner quick laps. It's not the fastest lap I've run, but I really don't think the key here is going to be all-out pace. I think a lot of the key here is at this track this week is going to be keeping the car under you, keeping your tires kind of healthier. You don't want to get them overheated. You don't want to wear them out too quickly. So if you're somebody that struggles with like all-out lap pace, Darlington might be a pretty decent track for you because it's going to be a lot more about saving and kind of understanding how the car's working. So, have some good finishes this week, probably. So, what we'll do, our usual, we'll watch the quick lap and then we'll talk about some of what I've done going through the corner. And we'll go from there. So that is that lap. So let's kind of take a look at it here. So heading down here into turn one, we've already talked about loading up the suspension, so we've done that. We've loaded up the suspension, and then we turn in and we turn in so that we just about clip that line and let the car ride out towards the wall and keep it up there for a little bit before you turn back down, and then turn the car in right about at this point. And almost clip this and ride your way out. And as you look through the throttle inputs and steering inputs through this corner, you're back to the gas pretty decent, but maybe not all the way. So you're going in, you breathe out of the throttle a little bit, and then get back after it pretty hard, and the car gets loose. You can see it kind of loosen up right here when I get back to the throttle. I'm back out of the steering. And then you're going to want to play with the throttle to keep the car where you want it before you're confident to get back to it and then chase it down this straightaway. And again, you're going to hit the rev limiter. And in this corner, I enter a little bit high and I let the car roll through. So I've moved the brake bias some, like I said, to the rear. So that helps the car be a little bit looser on entry so we don't immediately knock this wall down going into the corner. And brakes, brakes, and off the throttle. Kind of trail brake in and then get after the gas, but we're not immediately back to 100% throttle. We're kind of, again, using management throttle to keep the car where we want it until I'm confident that I can complete this turn and really fire it out of here and turn down where I want the car to go. And it doesn't get too loose coming out of that corner. It can, though, on a later run. Usually the corner that I have the most trouble with on long runs is coming out of turn two, because right about here in the middle of the corner, just about when you're getting back after the gas, after the throttle, it wants to rotate out. So you're going to have a lot of people that spin themselves down to the inside wall, which will be a common sight this week probably. So that is pretty much it for the one lap tutorial of the track. Now, another couple things I want to talk about are early race. Again, this ARCA series does not have cautions, so your single lap pace is not going to be the thing that saves you. So at the start of the race, if people are really gunning and they want to get by you, I would go ahead and let them by. I'd let them go on through because they're probably going to wear their car out and you're going to end up chasing them back down over the course of the race. In a practice session, I did 10 laps where I just really pushed after it, and I did 10 laps where I was about 3/10 of a second slower per lap. And what happened is I added up the times, and my 10 lap stint where I went all out and my conservative pace were nearly identical after 10 laps. What I mean by that is I added up like the seconds per lap. So where you see on the left side there, like 28.71, and I added up those 10 laps, and I had about 262 seconds to do 10 laps. And then with my conservative pace, it started out slower. Believe it or not, I had 262 seconds to do 10 laps. And they were identical within a tenth of a second. So that tells me that you're going to be killing the tires by really running it as hard as you can. So you're going to want to be conservative. Don't fight too early. Let other people wear their car out, and then you'll run them back down. Even if they're probably 3 or 4 seconds ahead of you, you're probably going to run them back down if you've taken care of your tires. So, and another thing, you're noticing I'm hitting the wall a lot in this practice session. That's completely okay. Darlington, for me, is a track that I found you want to try different things. So, looking at the definition of insanity, right? You're like you're doing the same thing over and over again, trying to get a different result. So, you really want to try different things going through the corners. So, I tried entering a little bit higher, entering lower, carrying the brakes into the corner a little bit more. Things like that. It's okay to try different things in practice sessions and find out what works, because a lot of the time you'll find out that the car can actually do more than what you might think it's capable of, and that you as a driver might be capable of more than you think if you just try different things. And some of those little tips that you might pick up by overdriving the car or not driving the car hard enough, you can apply when you start learning how to be faster. I hope that makes sense. So I'm good. That's gonna wrap it up for this video. Thanks again for tuning in. Once again, the response has been pretty awesome on these videos. I just really appreciate everybody watching these. It's been fun to make. I hope you're enjoying watching them. And as always, thank you. I hope you learned some more tips for the track. Yeah, tips. Messed up my own phrase. Hope you learned some more tips for the track. And we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.